Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. All together, please. Om Ajnana Tamarandasya Ganandana Salakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yukta Padakamalang Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raganatam Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvetam Savadutam Prijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padang Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakam Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dhina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapcha Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhana Sudadevi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Paditanam Pavnebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Vanchakalpa Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare So reading from Srimad Bhagavatam Canto 6 Chapter 3 Texts number 14 and 15. They're long verses, so we only have 14 on the verse, on the board rather. We'll chant that verse, and then I'll read the 15 and we'll go through it quickly. They're rather long verses. Please repeat. Aham Mahendro Niriti Prachetaha Samognir Ishaha Pavano Virinchihi Aditya Vishve Vasavo Ta Sadhya Marud Gana Rudra Ganaha Samsidaha Aham Mahendro Niriti Prachetaha Samognir Isha Pavano Virinchihi Aditya Vishve Vasavota Sadhya Marudgana Rudragana Sasiddha Aham Mahendro Niriti Prachetaha Samognir Isha Pavano Virinchihi Aditya Vishve Vasavota Sadhya Marutgana Rudragana Samsidaha Matajis? Vaishnavis? Okay, so I'll read the second verse. Anye cha ye vishva shriyo maresha brighu adhyayo sprista rajatamaskaha yesha hitam na vidu spritamayaya Satvam pradana api kim tato nye. So, please repeat, a very long verse. Please repeat, I, Yamaraj, Indra, the king of heaven, Niriti, Varuna, Chandra, the moon god, Agni, Lord Shiva, Bhavana, Lord Brahma, Surya, the sun god, Vishvasu, the eight Vasus, the Sadyas, the Maruts, the Rudras, the Siddhas, and Marichi, and the other great rishis, engaged in maintaining the departmental affairs of the universe, as well as the best of the demigods, headed by Brihaspati, and the great sages, headed by Bhrigu, are all certainly freed from the influence of the two base material modes of nature, namely passion and ignorance. Nevertheless, although we are in the mode of goodness, we cannot understand the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. What then is to be said of others who, under illusion, merely speculate to know God? Purport Srila Prabhupada. The men and other living entities within this cosmic manifestation are controlled by the three modes of material nature. For the living entities controlled by the base qualities of nature, passion and ignorance, there is no possibility of understanding God. Even those in the mode of goodness, like the many demigods and great rishis described in these verses, cannot understand the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. As stated in the Bhagavad Gita, one who is situated in the devotional service of the Lord is transcendental to all material qualities. Therefore, the Lord personally says that no one can understand him but the Bhaktas, who are transcendental to all material qualities. Bhaktimam abhijanati. As stated by Bhishmadev to Maharaj Yudhisthira in Srimad Bhagavatam 1.9.16, Nahi asya kahichit rajan pumam veda viditsitam ya vijinyasaya yukta muyanti kavayo pihi. O King, no one can know the plan of the Lord Sri Krishna, even though great philosophers inquire exhaustively, they are bewildered. No one, therefore, can understand God by speculative knowledge. Indeed, by speculation, one will be bewildered, muyanti. This is also confirmed by the Lord Himself in Bhagavad Gita 7.3. Manushanam sahasreshu kastid yatadi siddhaye yatadham api siddhyanam kastid mam veti tatpadaha. Among many thousands of men, one may endeavor for perfection, and even among the siddhas, those who have already become perfect, only one who adopts the process of bhakti, devotional service, can understand Krishna. Aham endro niriti prachetaha samogni isha pavano vrichihi aditya vishve vasavota sadhya marutgana rudagana samsidaha anyecha ye vishva srijo maresha brigu adhyo sprista raja tamasa kaha yes ye hitam na vidu sprista maya satvam pradanam api kim tato nye. I, Yamaraj, Indra, the king of heaven, Niriti, Varuna, Chandra, the sun god Agni, Agni, Lord Shiva, Pavana, Lord Brahma, Surya, the sun god, Vishvasu, the eight Vasus, the Sajyas, the Maruts, the Rudras, the Siddhas, the Marichi, and other great rishis engaged in maintaining the departmental affairs of the universe, as well as the best of the demigods headed by Brihaspati, and the great sages headed by Bhrigu, are all certainly freed from the base modes of material nature, namely passion and ignorance. Nevertheless, although we are in the mode of goodness, we cannot understand the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. What then is to be said of others who, under illusion, merely speculate to know God? Yes. So, Yamaraj is speaking here. Of course, Yamaraj is one of the 12 Mahajans. There are three corresponding authorities in the Vedic ontology, philosophical system. That is Shastra, that is the highest. Then there is the sadhus. The sadhus is the accumulation of great personalities, great acharyas who've contributed to the understanding of the Shastra. And the Mahajans are an essential part of that. In fact, I was just looking for that verse. It is here. Yes, here it is. Swayambho Narada Shambhu Kumara Kapilo Manu Pralada Janako Bhishmo Bhalim Vyasekye Vayam. Those 12 Mahajan and I myself know the real religious principle known as Bhagavad Dham, or surrender to the Supreme Lord and love for Him. It is uncontaminated by the material modes of nature. It is very confidential and difficult for ordinary human beings to understand. But if by chance one fortunately understands it, he is immediately liberated, and thus he returns home back to Godhead. So here in this verse, it explains that this Bhagavad Dham is freed from the modes. But in the previous verse, Yamaraj, he includes himself with the devatas who run different departmental affairs of the universe. Now, of course, we should not think, oh, Yamaraj doesn't know under the activities of the Supreme Lord. We should take this as an illustration of the humility of the pure devotees. Yamaraj, as a Mahajan, is surely with good comprehension of the activities of the Supreme Lord. However, through humility, he is including himself in this list. And now these demigods in the Swargalok and elsewhere, who run the departmental affairs of the universe, Yamaraj is saying they are freed from passion and ignorance, but they are contaminated by the mode of goodness. They say we are in the mode of goodness. So that is a contamination. We should understand that. It is not transcendental. Prabhupada terms it, and the Vedas, of course, term transcendence Vishuddha-sattva. Purified goodness. So, this is a very interesting point. Yes, in the mode of goodness, we may be very philosophical, balanced, tamodama, tapaso, cham, kashantir, arjivam, evacha, jnanam, vijnanam, astikyam, brahma, karma, swamavajam. We may have so many good qualities coming from the mode of goodness, but that will not help you to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead in His activities. Because those activities are completely free of the modes of material nature. In the beginning of the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj, such a great soul, he explains that the difference between kaam and prem. Kaam means I want to satisfy myself, dhanam janam sundaram, wealth, social position, sex life, the good things of life, soft cushion, nice bed, nice decoration, good music. I want to enjoy those things for myself. But prem means I want to use all my abilities, my facilities for the pleasure of Krishna. So that is the difference. In the spiritual world, everyone has seva bhav. They want to serve. In this material world, they want to serve, but they want to serve themselves. In the spiritual world, everyone is the unselfish servant of the Supreme and His devotees. In the material world, everyone is basically the selfish servant of their own self, their own ideas. So, whether it is goodness, passion, or ignorance, through your activities, still the underlying contamination is there in the material world. I think I'm the center of the universe, I should be satisfied, I should be the number one. This is more exaggerated, but the cipher or the paradigm for this is like people like Ravana. The demoniac, the Rakshasa, who's very exaggerated, and you will see in the seventh canto, at the beginning, it is explained there that generally the Rakshasa is in the mode of ignorance. He's the bloodsucker. He wants to take the energy of people and convert it for his own enjoyment. The Asura is termed for those who are in the mode of passion. They want to enjoy. But the Rakshasa, they want to enjoy selfishly also by control. We try to enjoy the good things, mode of passion. Dhanam, dhanam, sundarim. But when we become frustrated and the karma fall starts to operate, we go deeper into ignorance and then we want to control. You can see this. You can only eat so many chapatis, as Prabhupada said. You can only have so much sex life, much less than the pigeons or the monkeys. And then what is your enjoyment when you're burnt out? Enjoy by control. I'm the big man. I'm the boss. And you've got to submit. And therefore I inflate myself by submitting or suppressing others. And you can see this, isn't it? The foolish, as soon as they get some position, even if it's a pen pusher in the Nagapalika, they want to, oh yes, I will give you your license to park the motorbike, but you must recognize my magnificent position. And then all the way up to Ravana. Ravana is a big cipher for passion and ignorance. He wants to be the big controller. He wants to enjoy. And so this is basically the difference between the asura and the devata. The devata, in the mode of goodness, he wants to serve the Supreme Lord. But the asura and rakshasa, they want to enjoy and control the material energy. The devotee wants to serve Bhagavan and his pure devotees. Nirbanda Krishna Sambande Yukta Vairagya Uchite. He wants to use everything that is suitable in the service of Krishna, that is Yukta Vairagya. But the asura wants to use everything for his own self, his own sense enjoyment, self-aggrandizement. So he becomes a hellish, narcissistic, psychopathic, avoidable person. This is the difference. The asura wants to enjoy the energy, but the devotee wants to serve the energetic. The asura rakshasa wants to enjoy the energy selfishly, but the devotee wants to use the energy in the service of Krishna, even the material energy. So the Vedic prescription, as enunciated by the Mahajans, is Bhagavad Dharma. And that means Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasyam Sakyam Atmanivedanam. You all know these, right? So the problem is that the asuras are not neutral in this business. They are antipathetic to the service of the Lord. They're envious. However, the devotees, Ma Suchaha, are under the protection of the Lord. So everyone should have no worry about that. Even in the material world, the asura cannot touch the devotee. Rake Krishna Marike. Very good. We are under the direct shelter of Krishna, but we have to deserve that shelter. Now the thing is, one point in the Ajameya Leela, of course you know the story, but only a small excuse and Krishna will protect you. Huh? Ajameya had fallen down, bad association, young man not realized, not fixed in knowledge, not Atmaram, not situated in Bhava Bhakti. He saw that going on, but sinful life. But then just one little touch of the chanting of the holy name and Krishna was there, sending the Vishnu Dutas to save him. Huh? So doesn't this illustrate the mercy of Krishna? Doesn't this? Huh? Name Bhakti Pranashati. When Krishna comes, what does he come to do? He comes what? Why? For three reasons, he states, yes, go ahead. Huh? Yes, okay, that's one good reason. He says, huh? Paritranaya sadunam. That's the first reason he gives. Then, vanashaya tu duskritam, the duskrita. Jai, Sri Sri Gornitai, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta, Prabhupada's, Sri Guru Parampara, Radha Krishna, Lalit Vishaka, Giri Govardhan, Gomata, Shalagram Maharaj, Krishna Balaram, Sadhu Sangha Ki. No. Confirmed. So, and then Dharma Samstapanathaya, the third one. He wants to re-establish Dharma. Huh? Krishna Swadharma Pagate. Huh? You know the verse? Where is dharma, religiosity? Where is shelter in Kali Yuga? In the Bhagavatam. In this age, people will get light from the Bhagavatam. So every day, as we do, even in this way, we study the Bhagavatam, and this is essential. One devotee was telling me yesterday, he was studying the Shastra, and he was telling me that when he reads the Shastra, he just goes away into another. Of course, you're going into transcendence. Huh? Shastra Chakshus. You see through the eye of Shastra. You see Krishna through the eye of Shastra. So this is a very essential point. That do not just think chanting Hare Krishna with no understanding of Siddhanta will take you back to Godhead. Yes, everything is there in the Hare Krishna mantra. But can you mine the gems? Huh? Without shastric knowledge, without understanding. Therefore, the acharyas, Krishna himself, have given so many literatures that we can become absorbed and we can see transcendence through the shastra. On one lecture, Prabhupada says that, basically speaking, bhakti is the path, this Bhagavad Dharma, of hearing. You might say, oh, no, chanting is more important. But what do you do when you chant? You hear, correct. Can you do archanam, pancharati? Can you do archanam without being taught, without hearing? Can you make it all up? Well, this is the problem here mentioned. If you don't get things in disciplic succession from Guru, Sadhu and Shastra, you will simply speculate. Now, in verse 27 of Pakrita Ras Sutodhisthini by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta, he says those that are suffering under Kusiddhanta means upper Siddhanta, foolish ideas, they are not performing devotional service. He says it very plainly. He doesn't say they're doing a little bit or 10%. No, he says they're not performing devotional service. Devotional service, Bhagavad Dharma, as stated here, is a science. And then you can know Krishna by dedicating yourself to the service of Guru, Sadhu and Shastra in disciplic succession. There's four sampradayas, everybody knows, and four sampradaya acharyas, and they are in the sadhu category. If we study their literatures, we will be purified and we will come to the point where we're above these modes of material nature, completely. What does it say, that verse that everyone said? By regularly hearing the Srimad Bhagavatam, Nasta prayeshu bhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya sloke bhakti bhavati naistike. Next verse, tamo raja. By regulating the Bhagavatam, then all these lower modes were practically destroyed to nil. Prabhupada explains the mode of goodness, when passion and ignorance are gone, is like going to the airport. You can take off from there. You can't take off from the jungle. You have to go to the airport. So, mode of goodness is like being in the airport. You have the facility to go to transcendence. So, yes, you should cultivate samodama, all these mode of goodness qualities, and then combine that with serious study of the shastra and expanding your chanting. And then you will go above mental speculation to bhava bhakti. And in bhava bhakti, you will get direct realization of the Supreme Lord. You'll get swarup siddhi. But you cannot do that unless you follow regulative principles. And you do not chant regularly, and you do not humbly pray namaskuru, manmana bhavamad bhakto majaji, right? Always think of me. How? Devotional mood, then majaji, you'll do everything, then mam namaskuru. Offer your obeisances to the transcendental world, the transcendental pastimes, the transcendental pastimes that are revealed in this world. Offer your mam namaskuru. I don't expect anything in return. I only expect one thing, your little touch of mercy. Ai nanda tanuja kinkaram patitamam vishabeva bambudo kripaya tava pankaja stuti duli sadishim bichintaya. O son of Nanda Maharaj, I'm your kinkara, I'm your servant. Why does Lord Chaitanya say son of Nanda Maharaj? Why? Because Krishna, he is the Supreme Lord, the Supreme Master. But he is the servant of Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Maharaj, right? Oh, bring my chapels, Krishna. Sometimes in the temple, people steal the chapel. But Nanda Maharaj has them under good care with Krishna. And when he asks Krishna, what does Krishna do? He puts them on his head. Huh? So he said, you're the son and dedicated servant of your father, Nanda Maharaj. He's evoking that. That service attitude of Nanda Maharaj. So we should understand that. Huh? And this prayer, Lord Chaitanya, he's asking for a little mercy. Huh? Lord Krishna, he has unlimited qualities, but in the nectar of devotion, 64 are given. One is mercy. In the Krishna book, Prabhupada explains that for the fallen souls stuck in the modes, this aspect of mercy is the most important. So how to evoke that mercy? How to become subject to the mercy? Sadhu seva, sadhu sangha, service to the Vaishnav, respect, service. We cannot see the Supreme Lord, we cannot serve him directly without serving the order of Guru. Tadvini pratipatena pariprashnena sevaya. You inquire, but then you serve the order of the Guru. You serve the instructions. You take them as your life and soul. They are the active principle of spiritual life. You take the order of the Guru as everything in your life. And then you're properly situated. So, we want to get above even the mode of goodness. This is very important. Here, this is not a criticism of the devas. They are what's called sakam. In the Swargalok, we're on Bhuloka, Bhumandala. Then above that is Bhuvalok. And then there's Swargalok. And then there is Mahalok, Gyanalok, Tapalok, Satchalok. So they are administrating and they have a desire to serve Krishna in this way. I want to be Indra, I want to be one of the Maruts, I want to be one of the Vasus. Bhishma was one of the Vasus. He's in charge of water element. So this is very important to understand that we do not disrespect the demigods on the basis of this, oh, they're in the mode of goodness and we're going for Vishuddha Sattva. No. The devotee offers his respects to everyone. This is an important point. We don't think that we are equal. Men and women are equal. Matajis and brahmacharis are equal. No. The Vaishnav takes everyone as his superior. Huh? We don't think, oh, I'm in a better category than this person, this lady, this man, this woman, this devata. The Vaishnav is the servant of everyone. And he has that attitude. He has compassion rather than envy. That is the material desire. Ravana was envious of Ram. He wanted to take the energy, the Sita Devi, and enjoy. But the Vaishnav is the servant of Ram and the servant of Ram's devotees. This is important, that service attitude and humility, modesty, just like Yamaraj is saying here, I can't understand. This is most important. Nobody likes a proud man. Say somebody is a great musician, but he's proud. Do you want to listen to his music? His pride comes across subtly in his music. But if somebody has a little bhava, bhava for Krishna, even he's playing a simple melody, his music is beautiful, and it touches the heart. So this is important, that we must develop this seva bhav, dedication to the Vaishnavas, and dedication to Guru, and dedication to Bhagavan. That is Bhagavad Dharma. Not thinking, oh, we're more intelligent than these, and that's this, and then squabbling like children. A bunch of monkeys in the tree fighting over some leaf. No. What does Krishna tell Uddhava? He says, if you want, this is the Paramahamsa Samhita. Huh? It is even higher instruction than the Gita. He tells Uddhava, you must pay your obeisances to the hogs, dogs, camels and asses. Why? Because they are spirit souls. Now they're in that, that's their karma fall. But can you say that you're superior to any spirit soul? No. You have the same quality. And why should you feel belittled? You have the same quality as Krishna. Huh? You're not some half part or half quality of Krishna. You have the same nature as Krishna. But Krishna is the one absolute and we are the many tiny particles of absolute. So there's a counterpoint. And Krishna wants to reciprocate with us. And Krishna, he's unlimited in his mercy, generosity. So he makes every devotee feel special. He doesn't have a favorite son like we may have in the material consciousness. Everybody is the favorite of Krishna. Therefore, understanding that, we should understand that everybody is special to Krishna. What to speak of those who with faith have entered into the path of bhakti. And therefore we should give the greatest respect to everyone. What to speak of our god sisters and god brothers and our family in this temple. If this service attitude is there, then Krishna is pleased. But there again, of course, it is there. Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Chandra, they used to argue, right? And it is stated there, Chaitanya Bhagavat, that Lord used to enjoy their arguing. But that is in Vishuddha Sattva. When we're in the sadhana stage, we should be very careful. And that means giving respect, mam namaskuru, to Krishna and Krishna's devotees. So this is Bhagavad Dharma. Now the Sakama devotees, they understand these things, but because they're attached to some post, and they want to serve in that way, and they enjoy the facility, like some people need to be the temple president, or they need to have a desk and a salary to do a little service. But we have to be very careful that we are not going to Krishna for some return, or else we'll end up in Swargalok, Burloka. And then if we are offensive, we may have to go down, what? To the other seven lower ones. What is that? Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Mahatala, Rasatala, Talatala, Patala. I may have mixed up the order. What to speak of below Patala, where there is the hellish planets? Of course, the devotees generally don't do that. But if we become violently offensive, if we entertain offensive, if we become Guru Druti, we may have to see hell, corrective measure. But once one has entered the shelter of Krishna, then Krishna's mercy is always attendant. So we should always remember that. We may see imperfections in devotees, but Krishna and Srimati Radharani are only seeing the good. There's many things in the Shastra. Oh look, Krishna, this devotee is doing wonderful things. Why not bring him back to Goloka? This devotee is very serving other devotees. He's very compassionate. Why not bring him? Bring him closer, Krishna. So this is very important. Here also, the foolish material scientists have no idea actually how the material universe works, that it is under the control of the devatas. They want to make everything into just a clash of atoms and molecules. But actually in Vaishnavism, there's another point here in this verse, that in Vaishnavism, everything is under the control finally of a person. Just like in India, right? You have different departments, but it's the boss that matters. Especially in India, or you want your visa, no problem, I like your kirtan. So in this way, the personality overrules the laws, But the foolish material scientists, the empiricists, they think, oh no, let's not bring God into the equation. Let's turn atoms and molecules into the equation. Space, time, and energy, that's the only thing. Huh? Let's find out the laws of physics. But everybody knows in India, huh, that there's laws and there's lawmakers. It may not be very, traffic laws may not be very evident on the road, but we're assured they're there. They have laws about traffic in India, left on, you know. But there are there. I think there are traffic rules in India, yes. So they are maintained by personalities. They're created by personalities. Huh? So this is an important point. In Vaishnavism, it's well known in the Vedas, 33 million demigods in this sakam, in these different posts. You might, 33 million to run the universe? There's probably 55 million running India. They're running the whole universe from top to bottom. It's a very small workforce, 33 million. And they are empowered, just like the different departments in any country, what to speak of India. They're different departments, and there's always somebody who's the boss. Huh? And you fill in the form according to the rules, but then the boss says, oh, never mind about that. Right? The boss, the person, the lawmaker, the law maintainer is more important than the laws. Huh? Can bend the rules. So who is the ultimate lawmaker? Krishna. This is what this whole section is about, right? The Yamadutas thought, who are these Vishnu Dutas? They defeated us in argument, they're more beautiful than us. Everybody knows what the Yamadutas look like. Maybe a few lifetimes ago. Anyway, the Yamadutas are not known as very beautiful. In fact, they're very fierce. They have, anyway, we'll not go into that. But the Vishnu Dutas, they look like Vishnu. They're very beautiful, very pleasing. When you see them, you feel, ah. But the Yamadutas think, oh my God, I shouldn't have stole that money from the bank. I shouldn't have been kicking the cat in the street. Now I've got the Yamadutas kicking me. Huh? So remember that. There's consequence. But if you think that everything is atoms and molecules and there's nobody in charge, you think you can get away with everything. But that is self-delusion, because everybody does their sinful activities privately at night, isn't it? You can't say, oh, I think it's okay to steal, because you're doing it secretly, aren't you? You don't pinch somebody's chapels in broad daylight under his nose. You wait, Oh, he's gone for a bath, now I'll have them. Right? So you know it's not correct. That is Krishna, conscience. Don't do that. So we should listen to the super soul. This is the point. If you attain Sambandha Jnana, Veda Pramana, what is Sambandha Jnana? Hari Ishvara. The Supreme Lord is Hari. Sarva Shakti Mam. He has a range of shaktis and abilities that are unlimited in death, depth, and range. And then Rasavai Saha, he's the very embodiment of all rasa. So there's not just energy and arrangements, but there's rasa in this world. What are those rasas? Neutrality. But Lord Chaitanya says, I'm going to make the world dance with Charibhav. What are those Charibhav? Dasya, Sakyam, Vatsalya, Madhurya. And what are the secondary rasas? Laughter, astonishment, chivalry, compassion, anger, dread, and ghastliness. And then in the Nectar of Devotion, Rupa Goswami explains 33 vibhavs or sancharibhavs. They stir the ocean of the primary and secondary bhavas. So this is a great science. and it should be received in disciplic succession, and then we can transcend the modes very easily. And what will be the result? The topic is here, huh? The topic is in this verse, today's verse. Why is it so important to understand Krishna? What is, you know, somebody once did a research and they found that the verse that Srila Prabhupada quoted most was 4:11. Janma karma tame divyam evam yo vati tatpata. Purana janma. So if you can understand the divyam, the transcendental nature of Krishna, if you can understand him in transcendence, his birth and his activities, the topic is the activity, the leela, then what will happen? You will never take birth again. So Lord Chaitanya in the Shiksha Staka, he's saying, Janmani, Janmani, Ishvari, I don't care, I'll stay in this world. But Krishna's saying, if you understand me, I'll take you back. And then in the eighth canto, he explained, one who attains me never returns to this material world. So you have a chance, you have the means, you have the bhava in your heart, you have Swarup, you have the Maha Mantra, you're in Vrindavan, you have a great Acharya who's written endlessly books. But you have to supply the endeavor, the sincerity. Don't worry if you can't understand everything perfectly at the beginning, but progress in spiritual life means progress in Siddhanta. So rasa vaisaha. If you want that rasa, what are the other items of sambandha gyan? Jiva angsa, the jiva is the part and parcel of Krishna. And then jiva bandha, how the jiva is in the material world when he's bound by the modes. And then jiva mukta, how he is in the liberated stage. What is that verse, third canto? Muktir hitavan yata rupam swarupena vathishtati. This mukti of going into the Brahman is useless. It's not real mukti. Mukti pade. Sarvabhauma didn't like that word in the verse, so he changed it, bhakti pade. But actually mukti, real mukti is bhakti. Going into the Brahman is useless, but real mukti, it means swarupena avastiti, means to be situated in your swarup. That means bhava bhakti. Bhagavat dharma is what? Divided into two and then subdivided again. First, vaidhi, you follow rules and regulations. Then within that, you perform shravanam. You hear all the pastimes, all the leelas. And then you develop rag. Rag means attraction. Now if you're attracted to something and you pursue it in a rich, regulated way, then you'll get rati, attachment. Rag, attraction becomes attachment. And then you will get bhava and you'll get prem. But the start is shravanam, to hear. Of course, the foolish sahajiyas, they jump immediately to the rasleela. But one should hear all the shastras in a regulated way under the guidance of a good spiritual master, shiksha, diksha, guru, whatever. You should hear under direction and take suggestion and discuss your understanding. And that understanding of Krishna, that is your passport to transcendence. That is how you take off from the airport. You can't take off from an airport without a passport. Maybe if you're doing a local flight, that means you're going to go to Swargalok. But if you want to change your country, your situation, you have to have the passport to go through the Viraja River, the causal ocean, and to enter transcendence. You must have seva bhav. You must have that attitude. You must have that dedication to Guru, Sadhu and Shastra. This is very important. And if you just, as here Yamaraj quite rightly, he condemns mental speculation. This is man-made religion, right? I think God is a big flame. He's a big mountain. I think God is a big piece of energy up there vibrating, and he interacts with the modes and he creates all the devas. This is what's ruined India. Huh? Mayavad, that's ruined India. Demigod, Pancha Upashana, worship of the demigods is equivalent to Krishna. And then polytheism, all the devas, they're all equivalent to each other. They're all manifestation of the Brahman. Nonsense. And then casteism. Oh, you're this because you're born that. But in the Gita, Krishna says, Guna Karma Vibhagasha. Your work comes from your qualities. And you can change your qualities by Shastra, by sadhana. And then what else? Mythology. The idea that the Shastra, the Vedas, this is what the... what is the latest assault, not to speak of the political, is the Shastra describing these wonderful books, these wonderful, insightful things. They're just mythology. So all these foolish things come because of apasampradaya, because of speculative inquiry into the Vedas, or speculation under a tree, under a removed from sadhu sangha. If you assault, what is that verse? Sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sava shastra hoy, lava mata sadhu sangha, sava siddhi hoy. Because the sadhu, mahat sevam, dwaram, aho vibuktes, he is the doorway to liberation. If you approach the sadhu, tadvidi pratipartena, the person who's realized in Krishna, who's seen the truth, who's had darshan, who's had got bhava, who's heard the words of Krishna, taken them into his soul, then he's the touchstone. He's this touchstone. Because he can inspire you, yes, there is some truth beyond mental speculation. Now, what is Kali Yuga? Speculation. If you go to Delhi railway station and you say, where's the train to Calcutta? I want to go to Navadvip. And the wala, what are they called? Porter. He says, well, it might be platform 3. And then you go, well, he doesn't know because he's saying maybe. He's speculating. Then you go to another porter. And he says, well, it might be platform 12. Have a look. Take your bags over that hill, that big mountainous stairway. You go there, and there's another port. There's no train to Calcutta here. What's going on? It might be on platform 1. Have a look. So you open any science page in any magazine or any paper, and with a highlighter, could be, possibly, dinosaurs might have been, they may have had feathers. Right? You've all heard this, right? Is that knowledge? It certainly isn't. That was a disconfirmation. Confirmed. So, double. 3 in the Vedas, 3 is enough. But keep going. 9 is 3 times 3, so that's really sure. So in Kali Yuga, confirmed again. In Kali Yuga, everyone thinks that mental speculation is knowledge, right? You've seen on the television the scientist, a donkey.
No.
That's enough. Yes. He's in his white coat, that's his sannyas dress, right? And he's photographed behind, in front of a set of books that are covered with dust or should be used for toilet paper, and he says, yes, now we know genetics. And everything is because of genetics. A few years ago they had a different theory. Oh, genetics. Survival of the fittest. We're changed by our environment. No, you're born The genetics that you're born with is the genetics you die with. So where's the affectation by the environment? Genetics defeats evolution, right? Oh, you're descended from monkeys, survival of the fittest. The monkey is much better than if one gorilla came in here, we'd all run for it. And we're supposed to be evolved? The very stupid evolution. The gorilla can climb the tree, make a bed on top of the tree, can run 100 miles and then swim in the ocean and bite lumps of bone. And here we can hardly run 200 meters to the Krishna hall for a couple of chapatis. And we're supposed to be evolved from that magnificent creature? Oh, we developed a big brain. If you developed a big brain, you would have kept your muscles. Everywhere over the world, we're putting clothes on. It's winter now. Do the gorillas have that problem? Why do we lost our hair? That wasn't a very bad move. And the hair is very good. You hit a gorilla, you say, what are you doing? Huh? If you catch the thing, oh, it's cut. Huh? Survival of the fittest, survival of the weakest. Huh? What a load of nonsense. And this is what's being told. That's the new religion, atheism, speculation. Huh? Change it next week to another idea. Huh? Stumbling around in the dark, banging your head against a tree, and you think you're enlightened. That's what the scientists are doing. So we don't speculate because we have disciplic succession, and therefore we get the correct message. So, take advantage. You understand? Huh? Don't slip away. If you understand Krishna, you become transcendental to the modes, and you, by the passport of Seva Bhav, you will go to transcendence, and you'll live there eternally. Huh? Srila Prabhupada ki jai! And what's the fuel? Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. And it's the destination also. Sri Maha Mantra Ke Jai. Thank you all very much. Any quick question or what's for breakfast? Anyway. Yes. So those four things again?
Tolerance, mercy, friendship, and equality.
Jai. Sounds good.
Yes.
Right, so we're one big family. Yes, we have social etiquette and this and that, but it's all on the basis of friendship. Huh? We should have an open heart to one another. Right? So very good. That's mercy, that's tolerance. Your family members, you tolerate, right? Then everyone, we're not all perfect, so we tolerate. But we have friendship. Very good. Yes?
Thank you for the wonderful explanation. The reward of goodness in the magical world is always mixed with ignorance and passion. This was my own understanding.
The mode of goodness? Not necessarily. In the higher planets, this is important. We're in Burloka, everything is mixed here, goodness, passion. As you go up to Swargalok, passion and ignorance decrease. Once you go into Mahalok, Janalok, Tapalok, then pure goodness is there. And say for instance, as a rough, in Mahalok, it's like pure goodness plus 25% Vaikuntha, 75% mode of goodness. Then you go Mahalok, Janalok, then it's 50-50. And then when you go to Tabalok, it's like 25% mode of goodness, 75% Vaikuntha. In Swargalok, it's like 95% Vaikuntha, but one touch of goodness. And then as you go down, mode of ignorance becomes stronger, mode of passion starts to fade out into pure ignorance at the bottom, patala, illusory. So, that's how it is worked. We're in the middle now, yes. So, in this balance, this middle planetary system, we can't enjoy very well, but we don't suffer too much. So this is specially designed so that we can cultivate pure goodness through sadhana bhakti and also bhava bhakti. You understand? So yes, there are touches there, but once bhava and prema are established in the heart, they practically disappear because the consciousness is flowing to the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna Gornitai. So it is possible. But then if you are in that completely purified transcendental consciousness, then you're not really in the material world. So being in the material or spiritual world is ultimately a matter of consciousness, not location. So the pure devotees, they're manifestations of the spiritual world. Book Bhagavat and person Bhagavat, right? So it's important to think that we're not necessarily, and where is Krishna? I'm not in there, I'm not here or there. I'm where the devotees are chanting my glories. Krishna's that place, because he likes to be with his devotees, his pure devotees. So if you can call Krishna through the Maha Mantra in Kali Yuga, very powerful, the ultimate system, then you're living in Vaikuntha, even here, right? The traffic jam, all that beep, 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 that will sound like the kirtan of the Deliwallas. Hare Krishna. There's the cartels. You understand? Does that satisfy your question? Not very well, I see. Yes. But, yeah, it's nothing to do. It means transcendental consciousness. Ecstatic. Ecstatic attachment to Krishna. That will give you transcendence. Then you'll become situated in your swarup. At the stage of bhava, that's when you get direct communion with Krishna. And your relationship with Krishna in the form of your swarup will be realized. That is called Swarup Siddhi. So once that happens, once you arrive at realization of your swarup, your real identity, then your passion and ignorance, not there. Clear? But it's a matter of consciousness, not location, right? Therefore, Narada Muni, he's traveling all over the spiritual and material creation, right? Manifesting here, manifesting there, doing this, egging Kamsa on, then going to Vaikuntha, discussing with Narayan, right? So, that is available. Don't think that this is just that pure consciousness and the Leela of Krishna. That is only for Prahlad Maharaj, you understand, or Dhruva Maharaj, or the residents of Vrindavan. That is for you. That is the natural state, you understand. It's easier to be in the natural state, it's easier to be in Krishna consciousness than it is to be in Maya. If you want to be in Maya, Krishna has to make this bag of bones, right? It's a big problem, how to use this. In the spiritual world, there's no need of eating, mating, sex life, defending, sleeping. No, they're all part of Leela, but there's no necessity. You understand? Here we're dry, down here. Oh. We should understand the perfection of the transcendence. We should meditate on those activities. That's how we realize. And Lord Chaitanya has specifically revealed the highest meditation is to meditate on the exchange between Radha and Krishna, and Mother Yashoda and Krishna, to meditate on those spiritual bhavas, and the sakas and the servants, to meditate on that, and then it will resonate in your soul, purify you, and you'll get realization. Therefore, what is Bhagavad Dharma is there, Vaidhi, but what is the process of realization? First, Naam. But if I say mother, you'll all think of my mother. Right? But when you think of Krishna, you should think of the form. So the next stage is to hold that form in your heart. Krishna and his most intimate devotees. Read the Brahma Samhita. That is the gift of Lord Brahma. When we chant, we should conjure up the form of Krishna. Or else if we think, I just got to hear the mantra, hear the mantra, hear the mantra. No, you should become absorbed in the form. Then the guna, the qualities, 64 are given in the Nectar of Devotion. If you meditate on the qualities of Krishna, that will awaken your nature because you have those qualities. Huh? Krishna is a musician. Everyone loves music, right? Krishna is a joker. Everybody's a joker, right? Especially some of my friends. Anyway, so, and then Sangha. We should understand the bhavas and the moods of the Sangha. Through this is Shravanam. And then we understand the Leela, right? So we should make this progression. This is what Bhagavad Dharma, you see, Bhagavad Gan is a system, but the process of realization goes from Naam, Rupa, Guna, Sangha, Leela. So we should know what we're realizing within the format of Bhagavad Dharma. It's okay to say Vaidhi and then Bhava Bhakti. But what are we realizing in the middle, you know? So that's the vehicle, that's the process, but then what is inside the vehicle? Naam, Guna, Naam, Rupa, Guna, Sangha. Sangha is part of Leela. So we should progressively understand, we should study first in the beginning stage, what is the power of the name? Namadi Chintamani, Krishna, Chaitanya, Rasa Vigraha. You know, we should study the potency of the name. And then we should study the form of Krishna. In the Bhagavatam and so many literatures, the form of Krishna is there. The form of Krishna is here manifest in the temple, right? We should hold that within our heart, offer our chanting to the lotus feet of Krishna and Krishna's devotees. Then we should study Nectar of Devotion, the 64 qualities. What is the nature of Krishna? And then we should enter into study of the Leela of Krishna, the Nitya Leela, the Naimittika Leela. Jiva Dharma has all this in organized form, personally recommended by Srila Prabhupada. Every devotee should read that 100 times. And then you'll go back to Godhead, because that's what you'll be realizing. Janma Kama Tame Divyam. Right? Then, if I realize Krishna tatvataha, in truth, not as I speculate or I guess or somebody told me, but directly, then, Purna Janma, right? Finished. Clear? Srila Prabhupada ke, Ma Mantra ke jai, Breakfast Prashada ke. Thank you very much.